Hey there, subscribe to my channel and also press the bell icon so you will never miss any new update. Whenever we upload a new video, you will get a notification on your phone.
Two roads diverged in a wood. I took the one less traveled. That made all the difference. Robert Frost thus defined success. Nagarathar Star, Professor Pitchappan, septuagenarian scientist, tread this path to rewrite the story of mankind in India. What does it mean? Read on, cherish, and imbibe the values. The seed. Where all children study science out of compulsion, young Pitchappan was fascinated by nature. If you show a loaf of bread to a dog, saliva will drip automatically. Pavlov's experiment defined autonomous nervous control. This and a BBC film depicting how white blood cells combat infectious agents sparked the curiosity of the 12-year-old. Academic profile. In consonance with his passion, Pitchappan studied BSc and MSc in zoology, PhD on lizard immunology. He joined as a lecturer in immunology in 1976 in Madurai Kamaraj University to become reader, professor and coordinator of biology. He has attended and chaired numerous national and international conferences and published 100 plus research papers in journals of repute. Though retired from MKU in 2006, he never retired from science. From 2006 to 14, he carried out the Genographic Global Project and also served as Director of Research in Chettinad University 2010 to 15. Presently, he is the adjunct professor at ICMR, Andaman Nicobar Islands, and vice president of Nilgiri Adivasi Welfare Association. Voyage in research. Returning from Paris, France in 1981, Pitchappan started an immunogenetics laboratory at MKU and offered human kidney transplantation matching service to hospitals, including CMC Vellore from 1983 to 1993. If the human leukocyte antigen is similar in both donor and recipient, kidney or other organ transplants are considered self and not rejected. 3000 plus kidney transplant and 300 plus bone marrow transplant. Matching services, all from the university setup, was offered at a time when these were not available in hospitals in India. His mentor in Paris, the founder of the HLA system and Nobel laureate, Professor John Dossett, described Professor Pitchappan as rigorous, precise, and conscientious, a noteworthy prize from the legend. The period 1993 to 2003 saw him reach yet another milestone in his career, research on tuberculosis and leprosy. These Indo-French European Commission and the Wellcome Trust studies led to the concept of not all the infected develop a disease. Host genetics is more important in determining the disease manifestation. He remembers with warmth the advice of Dossett not to compromise in science and to work on bench. In 2001, Pitchappan and Oxford Group published their seminal paper on leprosy genome scan in prestigious journal Nature Genetics. The same year, with Dr. Spencer Wells, Pitchappan published the descendant of first man arriving in India from Africa 68,000 years ago in Viramandi near Madurai. NGS, PBS and BBC channels made these documentaries Journey of Man and Story of India and telecast in 2002 and 2007. Post-retirement from 2006 to 14, Pitchappan organized the Genographic Project in India, sponsored by National Geographic, IBM and the White Family Foundation. He sampled 12,000 plus men from all over India and investigated, Africa being the birthplace of mankind and India the cradle of ancient civilization. Man arrived in India 50,000 years ago, discovered languages 10 to 12,000 years ago, structured society 7,000 years ago, religion and caste 3,000 years ago. He asserts the study outcome will synthesize Indians and the world to live in harmony. Family. His father, Mr. N.M.A.R.M. Ramasamy Chettiar, was his hero for his sense of duty and affection towards family. Though he regrets not conducting the Sadabhishegam of his parents, he finds solace having cared his mother during the last 16 years of her life. He calls his wife Sarnavalli, gracious, cool, composed and honest to the core. She stands by him and travels through his life, a unique companion in sync with the time-tested Indian family values. The couple has got two sons and one daughter, all extremely successful business tycoons in India. Their six grandchildren and one great-granddaughter and their success stories keep their life memorable and complete. Life today. At 70, Professor Pitchappan is busy writing papers and participating in scientific meetings, the latest being the arrival of Nagarathar Nagarathar. Every day we learn new lessons, he asserts. Life tomorrow. Professor Pitchappan lives to breathe science. Down the line, he wishes to establish an early learning center and high-tech integrated agricultural venture as a model to empower the tribal and commoner in their own land. His most satisfying moment occurred on 24th September 2006 when President Dr. Abdul Kalam called him over the phone to discuss his work on the genographic. Yet, he never went after laurels. Do your duty, work for mankind, the rest will follow suit, he says. I am contented that I became a scientist. I have achieved most of the things I planned, helped and salvaged people, friends and families, created my own circle, brushed aside the unwanted. All without compromising quality in life and science, Pitchappan says. How many of us can say the same? IBCN wishes him all the very best.